Welcome to the prefabricated structures. I, Professor Ravi B. Tilaganji, will take you for the video. Welcome back. In this video, we will see related to the materials of prefabrication. So, materials which are usually available near us, usually also not available near us, we need to procure them from at a far distance, or if a site is at a remote place, we need to go to remote place and ask for the material such that it get procured at the site for preparation of the building or construction of the building. So buildings that are manufactured off-site and shipped later to the site or assembled at the final location, some of the commonly used prefabricated buildings. So which type of materials are required? So usually we are having a modern trend of concrete, steel, treated wood, aluminium, cellular concrete, lightweight concrete, ceramic products, etc. Some other all materials which are there available near or are at a far distance are one or the other way as a prefabricated only. Now we can say the windows panels which are not able to be placed into the particular section after construction we are going to place them, that type of materials we have to consider as a prefabricated first, and then we are preparing the concrete part and we will go for the particular fixing of the windows frame or doors frame like that. In fixing of this, we will get something known as modular coordination. So I'll be telling about modular coordination in the upcoming videos. There you are able to get what is modular coordination. Till that, let us see what are the materials mainly having in prefabrication, what are the other parts of materials wherein how we have to take, what are the characteristics of materials such that we are going to choose that material for the prefabrication. While choosing the material for prefabrication, the following special characters are to be considered. So some special characters are always there. If a person to person changes, a person to person or other special characteristics are also present. One person may be fast, one person may be slow. I may be fast for you, I may be slow for some. So in the prefabrications, the first and foremost and very important part is it should be lightweight. Means whatever the sections or whatever the elements we are going to prepare, it should be light in weight, able to handle easy and able to transport very easily, and the economic and sections and the size of footings. So such economic sections or the sizes of footings or foundations should match. They should be very light, but also they should work like a very much sound, means the sound in the part of strength. They should also have to bear the required amount of strength. They have to be designed for the required strength only. In strength criteria, we should not get diverted. We have to take the strength criteria most important. But in the weight criteria, we have to reduce the dead weight of the material, by which the erection vehicles will also not be having to have a huge vehicles. We can easily place them with a lightweight carrying vehicles, where can easily the lightweight elements or sections can be lifted and easily placed at the required site. Then comes the thermal insulation property of the material. So thermal insulation property means when we are able to have the heat outside in summer region, that should not have the effect on the structure. Usually nowadays or all in the olden days, stones were having the thermal insulation property. Then it again goes on in the modern way. Then we came into the bricks, normal bricks, which are used as a good insulation property. Then comes as the cement we are using with that as the insulation property. So till the material means outer temperature should not be coming inside the temperature, or inside temperature should not vary for the outside of temperature. We should maintain the temperature as well as the heat of transfer should not occur, or any kind of electrical connectivity should not be possible. So if that is there, anyhow the steel reinforcements are provided in the precast. Prefabricated means it is already precast itself only. So prefabricated thermal insulations has to be taken care at a high degree. We have to take a care at a high degree. High degree means socho ki abhi uske andar abhi current hai, matlab concrete ke andar humne steel dala hai. स्टील का कोई एक किनारा अगर वो करंट वायर के साथ जुड़ जाता है, उसके बाद में वो करंट वायर के अंदर से करंट स्टील वायर में अगर आएगा, स्टील में आएगा, तो जो पैनल बना है, मींस वॉट एवर द सेक्शन पैनल वी हैव बिल्ट और कंस्ट्रक्टेड और टुक एज द पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन, दैट वी हैव टू गेट सिक्योर्ड, मींस देयर विल बी द thermal insulation part. Then easy workability is nothing again considering for the lightweight of the concrete, and this lightweight of the concrete will make us for easy workability. Also sometimes concrete whatever we are to use, the material should have the easy workability of concreting, because concrete sometimes if we are waiting for a particular duration, it goes on setting, becoming hard, which will again have a difficulty for us to have the workability of the material. Durable in all weathers. So we have a seasonal weather conditions in our Indian continent. So for this part we are having a three weathers: summer, rainy, and the part of particular winter season. In these three seasons, we are going to face some durability of the structure, such that the heat is going to act on the structure and rains are going to make them get wet, and also sometimes in the joints of each element, it will get the seepage of water which is coming in the particular elements and also gets into the buildings. So this durability has to be taken care, and for durability part, the sections are prepared for easy part of thermal insulation and durability. So minimum wall thickness for a normal or conventional constructions, we usually take it as 300 mm or 230 mm, means we have to consider for prefabricated as about 100 mm or 150 mm, means it is about 10 centimeter to 15 centimeters. In this part we have to take more care regarding the things. Non-combustibility means they are not able to get burnt, so combustibilization will not be there if we are preparing. So whenever we are using wood, it gets burnt, but if we are using the steel or if we are using the concrete type of materials, then the burning part will not be there. There is no non-combustibility, means after they get burnt, they should not get turn, or they should not get hazardous type of nature with them in the particular part. Economy in cost. Economy in cost means availability is most important, which will again gets affected to the economy. So assume the site is at one place and we are having a abundant of materials available near the site, then we are going to have very economical cost for construction. And when this will be very economical for the cost construction, that time we can say that the things are going to be good if the same material has to be brought by a distance. So the we are going to give a leverage charge of the particular transportation also, which will increase our economy cost. So their economy will not be economical, and the economy or the cost of the whole building will go on increasing. So this makes the particular part, the material availability is most important. If one material is far away and other materials are at a near place, it can be manageable. And only one material is available and all other materials are at a very distances, then we need to take care about the particular preparation of building and the particular part of the materials, because the quality control is to be maintained throughout, from first point to last point, means from taking a material quality to the element quality, so it will remain in a uniform part itself only. There will not be any changes for the quality depreciation or any quality adherences. So we have to maintain the quality control throughout the preparation of the sections, means manufacturing of the sections, and then only the same sections are brought to the site for erection and preparing or constructing the house. Then comes sound insulation. Sound insulation, we have to maintain the sound insulation. Sometimes a very huge amount of blastings or some part of noises may be occurring outside the building. They should not get inside the occupancies. They should not have the difficulty of hearing that particular noise type of sounds inside when they are having a resting or living in the buildings, or some noises from the inside building not going for the outside. Such type of insulation of sound should also be prepared. Usually, because of the strong element, because of the core element, the sound goes on passing. Means if we take a particular steel rail, or if we take a railway line rail, a railway is going at some place, but when we place our ear on a railway line, we are able to hear that particular distance, or at some far distance, though we are not able to see the particular train is coming on that particular track, but we are able to hear that particular sound because of the solidity of the material. So now in this part, we need to prepare the hollow type of sections which will create the sound insulation of the building. So these were the particular characteristics of materials. So these are the same characteristics which are taken for the particular parts. So we need to have the particular things into mind, and then we have to proceed. Materials of prefabricated structure. So some of the materials are highlighted, such as already known to us, but we are also using these as the part of conventional building. The same materials can also be used as a prefabricated materials, wherein we have to stick on to the materials for preparation of the sections or panels or the elements of prefabricated structures. Aluminium is a very lightweight material. Steel is, compared to wrought iron or cast iron, it is a bit lightweight in material, as it is for the design purposes, means we are providing the reinforcement purposes. Only this type of steel is going to used, not the part of stainless steel cannot be used in the reinforcement part. Wood is used as a door panel, window panel, or sometimes frames of doors, sometimes frames of windows in such manner. Fiberglass. So fiberglass is very light material as compared to the normal glass, and normal glass may go get damaged or may get broken while we are lifting the particular element or while we are lifting the particular panel of a wall, wherein we are going to fix the glasses such as a window panels or window door sub panels or for the ventilator panels. In this part, these glasses, normal glasses, are always having a heavy duty, means the density weight is more. Because of that, the material may have the dead load, means the whole panel will also increase some of the dead load. But with the fiber glass, the quality remains same, such as the glass itself only. Only thing is the material is lightweight as compared to normal glass, and also sustainable while lifting the particular section or particular panel, which will not have any difficulty as compared to the normal or conventional glass. Concrete is again going with all the main required materials. We also may go for the superior concretes, such as self-compacting concrete, which will give us the good texture and appearance after casting of the panels. The panels may be of wall, slab, or columns, beams, because there we are not going to give any vibration if self-compacting concrete is used. And lightweight concrete, with self-compacting concrete, if we are able to modify and prepare it, then that particular concrete can be used it as the lightest concrete to lift the material or concretes in the structure. So the concrete is one more conventional material as well as for the prefabricated materials. Other materials are also there, such as we can go for other new materials or trending materials. Plastic is there. Sometimes we can say that the material non-related to the electric conductivity or anything such, that wood is also there, or logs of the woodens are also used. These all are the materials. Or we can go for the galvanized steel particular roofing system, or the corrugated sheets for the roofing system. Corrugated sheets are of concrete, or sometimes we get them as a glass pieces. Glass pieces are usually provided for the huge amount of openings. That time we will provide the fiberglass for the prefabricated structures. So these are the materials in detail. If we go for the materials, use of galvanized steel, gal volume as a chief material for buildings. So this is one of the steel coated with the aluminium zinc, and this is to protect the building against the corrosion or the rust or the fire, the corruption because of the rust and fire. It also provides a steel to protective covering to the prefabricated building. Almost all the components of metal buildings, such as beams, frames, columns, wall, and roofs, are made up of steel itself. Some synthetic materials are also used for walls and roofs to provide an enhanced security. A combination of both metal and cloth materials are used. Plastic flooring and materials can be quickly assembled and are very durable. Prefabricated materials used for small prefabricated buildings are steel, and for the wood, fiberglass, plastic, or aluminium type of materials. So usually we go for these materials because these are very cheaper as compared to the regular brick or concrete buildings. Materials like steel and fiberglass, wood, are used as a prefabricated buildings materials for sports buildings. These materials provide flexibility and preferred for making structures and accessories like stands and seats for stadiums and gyms. Or we can go for the other sports complexes, such as we can go for indoor sports or the stadiums which are constructed as outdoor sports, where we can utilize the particular lightweight concrete or the material of lightweight which can be easily taken into considerations, such as the things are going to get in the prefabricated structures. For making low cost houses, prefabricated materials like straw bellows is means we have to take a bamboo. A wooden bamboo is one of the straw which we can use this as the prefabricated materials. Then ferro cement consists of a cement matrix reinforced with a mesh of a closely spaced iron rods or wires. So usually we have seen the conventional building houses, in the walls we are going to provide some of the cupboards or some of the open space in the wall, such that up to the sill level we are going to build it. Up to sill level we will be building, then this part is left open and here again the lintel is going to come. To cover this part we will provide one of the reinforced materials, means the steel is provided and concrete chipping we are going to place on it, and then gets its plaster, and then we will be placing a racks or aluminium fixtures into that, such that it becomes as a one of the decorative part, such that we can able to keep some of the very important things, or we can keep the things which are very prize monies and all things we are going to pick. So this, the concrete matrix, whatever the cement matrix is prepared, that is also one of the prefabricated type. So in the same way we are preparing for the huge span and utilizing it as a wall panel, or utilizing it as a roof, or for the beam section, or for the column section. So this type of the techniques are simple and quick, wherein we can save our time for construction the conventional buildings. How we can save the time for conventional buildings means we can easily utilize the material for the good quality and good quantity. So with a small quantity of material also, correct amount of material is utilized for the required number of sections. So using prefabricated material, one can make durable, water and fire resistance, and cheap prefabricated buildings. So most of the prefabricated building materials are eco-friendly and affordable. Because of the cheap and of easily availability, such as the conventional building materials are the only same materials which we are using for the prefabrications, but the things we are preparing them, manufacturing the same conventional building into a prefabricated type, wherein this prefabricated type of construction usually goes in the hand in hand of conventional building only. When the conventional building started, the same time the prefabricated building also started. The things is how we can easily say that these are the water and fire resistant and cheap fabricated materials. Most important that these are affordable, because the materials, locally available materials, are very easy, cheap and affordable. So concrete, most of the concrete is used for the construction of prefabricated material. So concrete is of a good water and fire resistance, and the material which are required for preparing the concrete panels or concrete wall panels, concrete roof panels, slab panels as a prefabricated are also easily procurable to the plant, and materials which we are bringing at the plant can be utilized for more than one or two buildings. So the material wastage will not be there. Because of the material wastages, reducing in the material wastage, we are saving much amount of money, or we can make the cheap construction of prefabricated structures. So this was the video related to materials and their characteristics, and how the materials are used or utilized was able to explain you. So thank you. See you in the next video.